Jupiter Media presents Avasar, telecasting global opportunities.
Hello and namaste. Welcome to Avasar program. This program is all about education and educational news and views. And I'm your regular host, Sunil Acharya. Especially, we are trying to provide you full information about educational activities here in Nepal and abroad as well. Today, we are going to give you brief information about study opportunity in India, especially in Assam.
Avasar, telecasting global opportunities.
गुणस्तरीय शिक्षाबाटै प्रयोगात्मक ज्ञान सिप र दक्षता अभिवृद्धि गर्न सकिन्छ भन्ने उद्देश्यका साथ अडिग रहेर आसाम डाउनटाउन युनिभर्सिटीको स्थापना भएको हो। आसाम डाउनटाउन युनिभर्सिटी एक्ट 2010 अन्तर्गत स्थापित यस युनिभर्सिटी 50 एकरको क्षेत्रफलमा ब्रह्मपुत्र नदीको किनाराको उचाइमा रमणीय वातावरणमा अवस्थित रहेको छ। बजारले खोजेको दक्ष जनशक्ति उत्पादन गर्ने उद्देश्यले स्थापित यस विश्वविद्यालयले डिप्लोमा अन्डरग्र्याजुएट र पोस्ट ग्र्याजुएट तहमा थुप्रै विषयहरूको अध्ययन अध्यापन गराउने गर्दछ। नेपालका विभिन्न भूभागबाट ठूलो संख्यामा नेपाली विद्यार्थीहरू हाल आसाम डाउनटाउन युनिभर्सिटीमा अध्ययनका लागि जाने गरेका छन्। उत्कृष्ट पूर्वाधारका बीच स्पोर्ट्स कम्प्लेक्स, स्विमिङ पुल, जिम्नेजियम, सिनेमा हल, क्याफेटेरिया, उत्कृष्ट होस्टल लगायतका विषयवस्तुहरूले विश्वविद्यालयको अध्ययनलाई अझ रमणीय र सृजनात्मक बनाएको छ। विशेषतः म्यानेजमेन्ट, ह्युम्यानिटिज, इन्जिनियरिङ, प्यारामेडिकल, नर्सिङ, हस्पिटालिटी, टुरिज्म लगायतका विभिन्न क्षेत्रमा अध्ययन अध्यापन गराइरहेको यस युनिभर्सिटीमा प्र्याक्टिकल एक्सपोजर निकै राम्रो छ। आफ्नै हस्पिटल र विभिन्न कर्पोरेट हाउसहरू रहेका कारणले पनि विद्यार्थीहरूले अध्ययनकै क्रममा प्र्याक्टिकल एक्सपोजर पाउन सक्छन् भने अध्ययनपछि करिब 6000 भन्दा बढी विद्यार्थीहरूलाई आसाम डाउनटाउन युनिभर्सिटीले समय समयमा गरिने विभिन्न जब फेयर र अन्य क्रियाकलापहरूबाट इन्डस्ट्रीमा प्लेसमेन्ट समेत गराइसकेको छ। आसाम डाउनटाउन युनिभर्सिटीले त्रिभुवन विश्वविद्यालय र सिटिबिटीसँग पनि एमओयु साइन गरी समकक्षता लगायतका अन्य विषयमा आफ्ना क्रियाकलाप अगाडि बढाइरहेको छ। आसाम डाउनटाउन युनिभर्सिटीलाई लामो समयदेखि नेपालमा लक्ष्मी एजुकेसन कन्सल्टेन्सीले प्रमोट गरिरहेको छ।
नमस्ते, म शङ्कर भट्टराई, श्री लक्ष्मी एजुकेसनल कन्सल्टेन्सीको म्यानेजिङ डाइरेक्टर। विक्रम सम्बत 2067 सालमा नेपाल सरकारको इजाजत लिएर उच्च शिक्षा पढ्न जाने विद्यार्थीहरूको निम्ति देश विदेशमा रहेका उत्कृष्ट विश्वविद्यालयको खोजी गरी पढ्न पठाउनको निम्ति परामर्श दिने संस्था हो। यस संस्थाले भारतको आसाम राज्यमा रहेको श्री आसाम डाउनटाउन युनिभर्सिटी, जुन भारतको गुवाहाटीमा अवस्थित रहेको छ, 2010 सालमा स्थापित यस प्राइभेट विश्वविद्यालयको स्थापना कालदेखि नै नेपाल पार्टनरको रूपमा नेपालको भूगोलमा यसले काम गरिरहेको छ। र आसाम डाउनटाउन विश्वविद्यालयमा डिप्लोमा, ब्याचलर, मास्टर तथा पिएचडीसम्मका प्राविधिक कोर्सहरू रहेको म जानकारी गराउन चाहन्छु। आसाम डाउनटाउन विश्वविद्यालयले नेपालको त्रिभुवन विश्वविद्यालय र सिटिबिटीसँग एमओयु अर्थात् सम्झौता गरेको छ। नेपाली विद्यार्थीहरूको निम्ति सुहाउँदो नेपाली सुहाउँदो हावापानी, खानपान, रहनसहन भएकोले गर्दा र गुणस्तरीय शिक्षा दिने आसाम डाउनटाउन विश्वविद्यालय नेपालको पूर्वी सिमानाबाट करिबन 500 किलोमिटरको दूरीमा अवस्थित रहेको छ। आसाम डाउनटाउन विश्वविद्यालयले गुणस्तरीय शिक्षाको निम्ति कुनै पनि कम्प्रोमाइज गरेको छैन अहिलेसम्म। यसर्थ पनि नेपाली विद्यार्थीहरूको निम्ति आसाम डाउनटाउन विश्वविद्यालय उचित गन्तव्यको रूपमा रहेको छ। वर्षेनी सयौँको संख्यामा जाने विद्यार्थी नेपाली विद्यार्थीहरूले उच्च शिक्षा हासिल गरी नेपालका सरकारी तथा गैर सरकारी संघ संस्थाहरूमा आफ्नो योग्यता अनुसारको काम गरिरहेको समेत यहाँहरूलाई जानकारी गराउन चाहन्छु। धन्यवाद।
Awesome. Telecasting global opportunities.
Assam Downtown University was established through the Assam Downtown University Act 2010 in state of Assam, India in 2010. The university is located in Panikhati, Guwahati, the capital of Assam. The campus is based on 24-acre campus overlooking the Brahmaputra River. To explore all about opportunities on Assam Downtown University, international student experience and global standard education, we have with Mr. Jyotishman Datta, member of trustee Assam Downtown University. He has vast experience of 2 decades as management leader in different entities like Downtown Hospital and Downtown Enterprises Limited. Let's welcome him. Jyotishman, you're welcome on our show.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. We are quite happy to having you in this common platform so that we'll be able to clear all about the opportunities and challenges of Assam and Assam Downtown University. First of all, Assam Downtown University is popular in Assam. For our regular television viewer, would you please introduce Assam Downtown University?
Okay. I am Jyotishman Datta. I am currently the managing trustee of the Downtown Trust. I was also part of the founder team of the Downtown University when this was set up almost about 10 to 15 years ago. Officially, the university started in 2010 because the government passed the regulation in 2010 that the work for the university had started way back in 2004. So from 2010, it became a university and was giving degrees under its own name. So that is where the legal sanction came. So, but the institutes under Downtown Group have also been functioning from 1992. So 92, there was an Institute of Nursing, there was Institute of Paramedical Sciences from 1997. But as an independent university, we have been functioning from 2010. And from that, all the programs have been given degrees under our university. Previously, we used to be using other government affiliations to be giving our degrees. So the journey starts in 2010.
How does Assam Downtown University deliver global standard education there in local level?
See, the university primarily focuses in healthcare. Healthcare, as we know, is a huge sector and has a huge demand for trained graduates and technicians in the healthcare sector. We have a robust infrastructure and good people to guide students. So that is the reason that we have always emphasized on paramedical sciences, nursing sciences, pharmacy sciences, and health sciences. Because we know our students are getting real-life exposure in what actually is needed in a corporate hospital or any hospital for that matter. So that experience, I believe, is more important than what can happen in the class. And the university is special because our students have classroom teaching and also have an actual physical exposure in an actual working hospital. So that helps them understand the problem, understand the situation, and also how to face the problem. So these are the biggest reasons I believe that this university has excelled in these subjects. Besides that, I believe we are a very technologically savvy university. We can understand when COVID hit 2 years ago, there was a lot of problems as to how to deliver your classes. But our university has been having a learning management software way before COVID. So when COVID hit us, all the students' notes, their classes were already uploaded in video formats. So for us, even teaching the students is much easier. So I believe technological savviness makes us very competitive in the global standard.
There are many Nepalese students from eastern and western part of Nepal. Especially, what is your experience with Nepalese students? Are they doing well there?
Nepalese students are very shy, but they are very sincere. That is one thing that we have to say. They do not talk much, they listen more, and they're very serious about their education. And a lot of Nepalese students want to go back to Nepal, settling in India. And they all want to work for some government department or some project if it is possible, or some prestigious government-aided or government-functioning company there. So that's a good experience. We've had a lot of Nepali students who've been toppers of the batches, who have excelled, but they're very shy, but they listen well and they're very sincere. So that's a very good feedback that all our faculties and deans have about the students. And so everyone looks forward to students from Nepal.
How does Assam Downtown University help international students in this COVID pandemic?
See, as I mentioned to you that we have adopted a lot of technological devices before COVID itself. So our classes have been happening online. You can check with any of our students. We are one of the few universities, even before COVID, if say you have a class in maths, what you will study is already uploaded in your software. You can log inside. Every student has a unique login ID. So they can go use any computer login. They can check on which day, what class is available, what will be taught, notes. Even for practicals, the videos are made by faculty and are uploaded. We also run an additive learning channel in YouTube, where a lot of videos of class lectures are uploaded. So students can also see the videos there. If by chance there is an internet connectivity problem, say the class is scheduled at 12 o'clock, they are not able to attend at the same time, they also can go and check the notes which are presented in video format in YouTube. So we give that flexibility, which is already provided via the software that is available, and all students have login. They can study a little bit at their convenience. I'm not saying it is as good as classroom teaching, but understanding the situation, this is the second best solution that we can provide. And our students more or less have adapted to it. Our examinations are also held online.
During our journey program, we are visiting in different study destinations and talking with international students. They are often sharing about university infrastructure, accommodation, and the facilities. In this case, how does Assam Downtown University supporting international students regarding accommodation, infrastructure, and facilities?
Our international community is slowly getting very vibrant. We have students from Nepal, but then Bhutan being closest to us, we also have students from Bhutan. Right now, we're getting a lot of students from Bangladesh because our first batch of students from Bangladesh have passed out. They are working there, so the response has been good. So a lot of students from Bangladesh. In the few coming years, we are looking to target students from Myanmar and the neighboring countries. So students are like, for all the classes are the same, but for international students, there's a separate office dedicated for them. If they have any problem, they need any help with accommodation, they can go to a separate office where there are separate support staff who help them out. There are certain hostels close to the campus which are only housing the international students. Plus, if the international students, especially Nepali students, are looking at hostel accommodation within the campus, we give them priority. And regarding food, you can understand with the region, the food more or less is similar. So food has not been a problem for all the students from, say, Nepal or the neighboring countries. So that way, they are much comfortable studying here.
How Assam Downtown University alumni are spreading over the world? After completing Assam Downtown University degree, what sort of the exposure a student can grab?
See, a lot of students is that there's two issues there. A lot of internships are available for the students. Internships can be done by the students in India itself. There is no problem. But for international students, we have a huge placement drive that is happening at the campus almost multiple times a year. But in some cases, the international students are looking at jobs in India. Especially for Nepali students, the legality of working in India is not too complicated. So they can work in Indian companies. But as I mentioned before, most of the students are looking forward to go back and work in Nepal. So as equivalency has been taken in Nepal, a lot of students are applying for jobs in the government sector, government-aided sector, and also private sector, and working happily in Nepal. We have a student from our university who is in nursing, went to work in Nepal. In fact, now she has even moved on to Australia to work as a nurse, registered nurse in Australia. So students choose the path that they want, but obviously technically they are sound, hence the job has not been a problem no matter what they choose to do.
Does Assam Downtown University offer scholarship to international students?
See, we have some blanket scholarships available. We also are teaching students free of cost. Downtown University has been a non-profit university. So if you have in India, we have a concept of below poverty line. I believe similar concepts are there in multiple countries in Nepal. So if you have a certain percentage, like you have a 60%, which is a basic standard for merit, and you have a BPL card that you belong to economically weaker sections, you can even study free in our university. So these are standard policies we've had from day one. Besides that, based on the percentage of marks you've scored in, say, your higher secondary or class 12, you have scholarship schemes. Plus for Nepal, we have standard scholarship schemes where up to 25% to 50% scholarships are also given to students, because we want good meritorious international students. And Nepal is one of the best places where we have good students internationally. So these are the schemes available. I believe last few years, even a few students have studied absolutely free of cost at the university. So we are open to anything. It is not a question of fees should not be the main issue for students not being able to study at the university.
What are the popular courses at Assam Downtown University?
Most of popular courses are the healthcare programs, pharmacy, paramedical sciences, allied life sciences like microbiology, food nutrition. because of our background in healthcare, we have very robust support for the students who are studying here in terms of practical exposure in the hospital and the healthcare centers. So these are some of the most popular courses. But in India, for the last few years, there has been a huge reversal in the IT boom. And IT is kind of rebooming again in India. So a lot of our IT students are also getting very well placed nationally and internationally. Hence, there's been a huge demand for IT programs at the university. It's not just BTech in engineering, but also programs like AI, machine learning, cloud computing. So we are offering various degrees with specialization in that. And for the last few years, there has been a lot of demand in these programs.
Is there any MBBS or BDS courses going to launch recently in your Assam Downtown University, because you have hospital and other infrastructure as well?
Not currently, because the regulations are very different for MBBS and BDS. So currently, we have no plan to join that sector.
How does Assam Downtown University collaborate with other universities and institutions to deliver global standard education?
See, the system is very different now. Initially, there was a system pre-COVID that we had guest lectures from outside universities coming. Today, we have a very different system going on in Assam Downtown University. As I mentioned, our students are studying in the university, but are also eligible to take online short-term certificate courses from global universities. We have tied up with Amazon Web Services. We have tied up with the leading edtech platform in the world, which is called Coursera, which has the best American university certificate programs. So our students, besides the classroom coaching or whatever you call the learning, they can also have access to these platforms where free of cost, because the entire cost is borne by the university. Students can take additional certificate course from the best universities in the world. They can learn the best IT, cloud technology, cloud computing programs from Amazon, which is the largest cloud server company in the world, which are already embedded in the program. So students in their free time can also learn. So I believe it gives a huge exposure that there's a Indian system of classroom education, but also a global system of online education, which they have exposure to. So they can learn from the best systems across the world. So I believe that gives them the best exposure. And we have always started this almost 2-3 years ago. And the students are coming up with multiple certificate courses besides the main degree programs.
What are your plans to promote Assam Downtown University in Nepal?
Yes, I believe once COVID recedes and there's better, easy for us to travel, we would like to do a lot of workshops, a lot of seminars. Our faculties would love to travel, look at research associations with Nepali institutes, and vice versa. We would like to have a lot of academicians from Nepal visiting us, having a look at the university. We have also started the system where our faculty are teaching in Bangladesh. There are certain universities in Bangladesh where certain classes are online taken by our faculty. And in the next month, two of our faculties are moving to Dhaka to teach for 2 weeks in the universities there. Similar setup we would love to do in Nepal and get the best faculties from Nepal as an exposure to come and teach with us for 2 weeks, and our faculties to go and teach there for 2 weeks. Similar programs are being started with institutes in Thailand, institutes in Malaysia, so that our faculty can learn what is the best teaching practices in other universities, and those universities can learn what are the best teaching practices in us. But having said that, COVID has been a little difficult because you can understand physical traveling has not been as fluid as before. So I believe in the coming years, this will move and all our faculties would have some experience in teaching at other universities globally. And I believe that experience they can come and impart to the students on campus later.
Okay, especially Lakshmi Education Consultancy is promoting Assam Downtown University here in local market since very long back. So what is your experience with Lakshmi Education Consultancy?
See, Lakshmi Education Consultant is not a consultant for us. They are partners in our growth. They have been with us from day one and vice versa. They have been helping us with inputs from Nepal. We have been talking to them about what we can do for the overall Nepali society. For us, when we enter Nepal, it's not only a question of students. Even when the earthquake came, we have sent relief material to Nepal, and we are also willing to offer as much scholarship as for Nepal. See, as a university, it's not just a question of students. Getting students is one part of the relationship. The relationship between a society and the university is much larger. Man, we are working, our alumni are, for example, there in Nepal. We would love to work with them and do even projects physically there. We also did an educational, not fair, that is something only, we also did a job fair in Nepal. Because we wanted to, so as a university, we are very good at getting companies to give jobs to our students. So we've done that in Kathmandu to show that, yes, we can do even in Kathmandu that. So why can't we do it physically in India? Similarly, now we are working on a lot of startup ideas. We would love to even open up for students of Nepal. Doesn't matter which university they are studying in. If they have great startup ideas, why don't we work with our incubation center to even get funding? So where Lakshmi comes in, they are a partner in this whole association. It's not just a question of student sourcing. This whole partners where whatever our expertise are, we can provide to the overall Nepalese society, irrespective of whether there are students studying or not. That is just one part of the relationship. So Lakshmi is the bridge that connects us and Nepal. So that is how important they are.
Jyotishman, those students and parents who are really interested to enroll on Assam Downtown University and explore their career in Assam, what is your message to them?
I think I've mentioned various aspects of Assam Downtown University. As a culture, Assam is very similar to Nepal. So when your ward is coming and studying here, they will not feel they're coming to an entirely different country. But having said that, the infrastructure, the labs, the what I mentioned is that embedded online learning practices that we have started are very Western, so to say so, which are not even available in a lot of currently best Indian universities or Asian universities. So you have a very different, vibrant, global learning environment very close to your home in a place which is culturally very close to you. So I believe these are the great benefits that the university provides. I can understand temporary COVID has been a bit of a problem, but there's one thing I can provide you. COVID has not delayed anything in Assam Downtown University. 2021 batch has already got their degrees. There has been not even 1 month delay in any education delivery in the university. 2020 batch has got their degrees. 2021 batch has already given their exam and got their degree. So as a university, we have not let COVID hamper any education service or the education of our students in any way, and they have not losing out even in 1 month. So that is one great benefit that this university has provided that very few other universities have been able to do even globally. You can even check with all our students, 2021 batch has already finished the exams and passed out, while most other universities are even struggling to hold examination. So this is where we are, that we'll give the best to our students. They should not miss out or be harmed in any way, doesn't matter what the situation is. So that's a promise we make to our students, and that's a promise we'll keep no matter what the situation.
Thank you so much for your valuable time and thoughts.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Today we have talked with Jyotishman Datta, who is member of trustee of Assam Downtown University. Hope you have full information about Assam, opportunities and challenges of Assam too. With this, we are at the end of the session. Thank you so much for your valuable time. We will be back in next episode. Till then, take care. Bye.
Awasar, telecasting global opportunities.